Hello dear students, today I am going to discuss with you financial accounting subject. In that the chapter form accounting I am going to discuss with you. So here come to the point, what is the meaning of form accounting? We know the meaning of form and already we know the meaning of accounting. So because we all are commerce students and come to the point, form accounting means simply applying the techniques, principles and methods to maintain the record of form activities. It is treated as a form accounting. Then come to the point, what are the form activities? Form activities are horticulture, agriculture, pisciculture, dairy, poultry, nursery, agriculture. These all are the things are we treated as a farm activities, and the farmer is simply not only involved in the agriculture, he may engage in so many activities like horticulture, pisciculture, dairy, poultry, so many things, sericulture. Then come to the point, there is a kinds of farm transactions. So there is a kinds of farm transaction. First one, that is a cash transaction, credit transaction, exchange transaction and notional transactions. What does mean by cash transaction? It is a transaction in between two parties with cash. We can exchange things or products by using the cash. So cash transaction, the name itself tells what it is. Then next one, that is a credit transaction. What does mean by credit transaction? It is a purely credit based transaction. So in that, we two parties are going to be two parties are involved in the credit basis transactions. So next, exchange transactions. In here, products or things are going to be exchanging in between two parties. Then notional transactions. These transactions, notional transactions, are those transactions which are made between the farm and household of the same farm. For example, consumption of a farm output by the household. So this is a notional transaction. And another one thing, that is a use of land owned by the household by the farm. These all are the example of notional transaction. Then come to the point, some are the features of a farm transaction I noted here. Main some of the important features of a farm transaction I noted here. See, farming is like a family business. So it is not only related to particular person of the family, it is related to all the family members. So it is going to be treated as a family business. Then family member put their labor. Apart from the outside worker, the family, each and every member can put their labor for farming activities. Then payment of wages in kind. The wages we can made through the cash, and also we can made any kind of the crops. So in here, farming activities, wages may be in any kind. It may be any kinds of crop which is grown in the our farm. Then next, a farmer engaged in more than one activities. Already I told you that is a farming activities are a lot. So the farmer can engage in so many activities, more than one activities. He may be involved in agriculture, then horticulture, pisciculture, dairy, poultry. So many activities are there. He can engage in more than one activities. Then next, that is the farming activities are prone natural calamities. This is a very important feature, because farming activities mainly prone natural calamities. Natural calamities like earthquake, flood, drought, these all things are mainly effect on farming activities. So these all are the main features of a farm accounting. So this is all things are related to theory part of farm accounting. Next class, let's some of the for accounting format are there. As per your syllabus, there is a cattle account and corn and crop account is there, poultry account is there, fish account is there. So these all things are very necessary to discuss with you. So today I am going to discuss with you some of the format. So format I am going to discuss with you. See here, there is a format. Format of a crop and corn account for the year ended. So this is a how to solve related crop and corn account information. We can solve by using this format. So see here, first we have to put here whatever the opening stock. Opening stock of corn, growing crops, fertilizers, whatever the opening stock is given in the problem. Then wages and salaries, crop expenses, livestock expenses, rent and taxes, irrigation expenses, repairs, other expenses, depreciation, machinery equipments. These all things are which is related to expenditure. We have to put simply debit side all the expenditure. Then come to the point about a credit side. Here sales, sales of corn, straw and whatever the drawings, the proprietor, the himself consumed things, we treated as a drawings. So that one also right here. Then livestock, crop used by the livestock. It means livestock section is going to be used the crop and corn, some of the crop and corn that time we have to livestock, crop used by the livestock, right, credit side, that is a livestock. It is the income for us, and in livestock section we have to treat it is in debit side as a crop account. So it is a vice versa. Then closing stock of corn, growing crops and fertilizer. This is a very simple format how to solve the crop and corn accounted related to problem. So this one is crop and corn account. Next, there is also another one format which is related to cattle account. Cattle account for the year ended, it is a format. So see here, in here expenditure and incomes are given. Then say there is a numbers columns also is there. Here also numbers column is there, income side. Then amount and amount column. So number, why it is given in number column? Because in cattle account we are counting the cattles, how much cattles we purchased and how much sold and how much born and how much died. These all things are we have to going to calculate. That's why there is a need of numbers column. See, in first in cattle account, first we have to consider income side. See here, by sales, whatever the in problem sales given, number of cattle sold, that is the numbers and amount we have to write here. Then cattle slaughter, how much cattle are slaughtered. Then sales proceeds of that one, less in that, less expenses which are related to slaughterhouse. Slaughterhouse expenses we have to deduct, remaining amount we have to write here. The number of slaughter cattle we have to write this in number columns. Then sales of carcasses also, number of cattle which are carcasses, then amount of that, then closing stock of cattle we have to write here. Then come to the point expenditure side. Here opening stock of a cattle which is available in number and amount. Then purchases, how much cattle we purchased during the year and amount. Then we need to calculate here calves born. How to calculate calves born? In here simple term I will explain you here. Whatever the sales number of cattle sold, that one we have to take, then add in that cattle slaughtered cattle we have to add that one, then number of cattle carcasses, that one also we have to add, then closing stock of a cattle. All the numbers only we have to add numbers. In that we have to less opening stock of a cattle, only numbers, then purchases of a cattle, then we get automatically how much cattle survived. In that, if problem they have given how much died cattle. If we add died cattle, then we get the how much calves born. We get how much calves born. It is a calculation part of a calves born. So right here calculation of after calculating the calves born, we have to write calves born. In that we have to less died, then automatically survived amount, survived numbers of cattle is write in numbers column. Then cattle food, one more thing is coming, cattle food, how much is opening stock and purchased, we have to add these two things and less the closing stock of a cattle food. Then remaining amount we have to write in amount column. Then whatever the expenses related to cattle account, so write all these expenses. Crops and corn, which is transferred to, that one also we have to write here. Wages, insurance, depreciation, other expenses, profit transfer to, so these all things expenses if we write, then automatically total in all the income side total we have to write here. Then after that we have to calculate all the totals of expenditure side. The difference between the both is treated as a profit. So that profit is transferred to general and P&L account. So same time here numbers of all the income side cattle we have to total it here. Then that one amount is put here. Then numbers, it is also going to match, and this one also is going to be match. So this is how to calculate related the problems cattle account. Then next another one important as per your problem. Already I explained crop and corn account and cattle account, and another one is livestock account for the year ending. Here livestock also simple, in very simple it is problem. See here format how it is, by sales then by closing stock. Whatever the sale sold during the year, we have to put in the amount only. Then closing stock of livestock and feeding materials, we have to write these two only in the credit side. Then same time we have to write opening stock of livestock and feeding materials in the debit side. Then purchases of livestock and feeding materials. Then livestock maintenance, that is all expenses, which is crops and corn transferred amount if is available. Then also then all the expenses, repairs to said, insurance, depreciation, these all things we have to write. Then difference between credit side and debit side, we get the profit, that is that profit is going to be transferred general P and L account. So it is a very simple format which is related to livestock. Once I will repeat, all we in credit side we have to write sales and closing stock, in debit side opening stock, purchases and all the expenses we have to write. So then we get the profit from livestock account. So this one is very important. There is a three accounts are very important, that is a crops and corn account, then next one cattle account, then another one is livestock account. Then another two formats are given in your book, that is a dairy account and a poultry account. You can refer that one also, is the available in your book. So next I am going to explaining the one of the simple journal entry related problem about a form accounting. See here, one of the illustration is given in your book. See, in that pass the necessary adjustment entries for the following. So see here, owner of the farm has used milk worth rupees 600 from dairy section and eggs worth rupees 400 from poultry section. Next, Workers of dairy section have consumed milk worth ₹500 from dairy section and eggs worth ₹300 from poultry section. Then next, workers of poultry section have consumed milk worth ₹250 from dairy section and eggs worth ₹350 from poultry section. This is information given. So based on we have to first the journal entries. So see here, once I will explain what is the problem, what is the information they have given. See, owner of the house, owner of the farm has used, it means the owner himself consumed the milk of ₹600 from dairy section. The dairy and poultry both related to owner only, but he consumed that 600 from dairy and 400 from poultry. So that's why it is the owner himself consumed. It is treated as a drawings account. Then next one, workers of dairy section have consumed milk worth ₹500 from dairy section and eggs worth ₹300 from poultry section. So here already in one of the features of a farm transaction I explained, that is the wages is given in cash or in any kind. In any kind means here the workers of dairy section consumed milk 500 from dairy section and eggs 300 from poultry section. So in that the owner treated these consumption from workers as a wages. So it is in kind of wages. Then next, workers of poultry section workers are consumed milk worth ₹250 and eggs worth ₹350 from poultry section. So this is how workers consumed from both the section related to poultry section. Poultry section workers have consumed from both the section they have given. So by referring these information, we have to pass the journal entries. See here, journal entries. First two information which is related to owner himself consumed. So that is a drawings account debit to diary account to poultry account, because diary account 600 milk he consumed and poultry account 400 eggs the owner consumed, total 1000 is going to be debit to his drawing account. Then what is the narration? Being transfer of the value of milk and eggs consumed by the owner, where it is transferred? It is transferred his drawings account. Then next, the dairy section workers consumed things it is treated as a wages. So wages of a dairy section account debit to dairy account to poultry account. Dairy accounts how much milk they consumed? 500 and poultry account 300 eggs consumed. So total 800 it is debited to wages account of a dairy section workers. So here narration, being transfer of the value of milk and eggs consumed by the workers, which section worker is they all are dairy section. Then next, third one, wages of poultry section account. So here poultry section workers consumed the milks and eggs from both the section. That's why poultry section account wages debit to dairy account to poultry account. How much amount? From 250 dairy account and 350 from poultry account, both it is 600. 600 is going to debited to wages account of a poultry section, because the workers of a poultry section has consumed these all the things. So what is the narration? Being transfer of the value of milk and eggs consumed by the workers. So workers of poultry section, this is a journal entry. We have to pass this kind of a journal entry. Then another one is there here, we have to pass combined journal entries too. They asked also pass the combined journal entries. Here one more thing is there in your See here, combined journal entries, which is in your book, that is problem number 6. It is related to how to fast the combined journal entries. The proprietor of a farm has consumed rupees 800 from poultry section and rupees 2000 from dairy section, whereas the workers of poultry section have consumed 4000 from poultry section and 3200 from dairy section. Then next, similarly, the workers of dairy section have consumed rupees 1600 from poultry section and rupees 400 from dairy section. Fast the combined journal entry for the above in the books of the form. So in previous problem, it is a separate journal entry we had fasted, but here combined journal entry they asked. That time we need to first calculate the things. So here 800 and 2000, the proprietor himself consumes, that's why drawings account debit 800 and 2800 debit. Then poultry section workers consumed 4000 and 3200, wages account poultry section, so 7200. Same time dairy section workers consumed 1600 and 400, so wages account of dairy section 1600 400, that is a 2000. These all are the debited amount. To where we have to credit that all things? To poultry trading account, because from poultry trading account they have used 800 4000 1600, these all things from poultry trading account, total is 6400. Same time dairy trading account, that is a 2000 3200 and 400, that is a 2000 3200 400, that is a 5600. This is a combined journal entry, how to fast combined journal entry. So this one is a exercise which is given in your book section B. So another one, solved illustration are available in your book, that is a this one illustration 5. It is related to combined journal entry, you have to refer that one also. It is also asked for combined journal entry, same, but here they did calculation for separately and after that they fasted the journal entries. So refer this one and solve the problem. So next video I will continue the problematic part. Thank you.